There are several places in our area that make, store, and handle the same kinds of farm chemicals. As KMBC 9's Michael Mahoney found out, some parts of the process are not inspected for safety. Michael?
Indeed. Len, we're in the small northwest Missouri town of Rushville, and this is a small fertilizer plant facility behind me. There are about 1,000 of them in both Kansas and Missouri combined here. Now, the states of Kansas and Missouri regulate how some common forms of farm fertilizer are handled and stored and kept, but neither state regulates the manufacture of fertilizer. Missouri has 199 such facilities storing a very common farm chemical, anhydrous ammonia. Kansas has more than 700. And almost all of them store fertilizer as opposed to manufacturing it. Both states inspect the handling and the storage sites annually. In Kansas, it's done by the state. This plant in Atchison, not far from here, is a large commercial storage facility. In Missouri, the process is handled by the University of Missouri. And it's one of five states that do it that way. Another one is the state of Texas. Now, Rushville here is a tiny, tiny town. Almost nobody was home here earlier today, and some folks who were here at the plant buying goods didn't want to talk on camera. But farm fertilizer is not volatile by its nature. It's not like grain dust from a farm elevator. So nobody around here has a good idea of what happened in Texas or why the explosion was so powerful and deadly. But if the state doesn't regulate the manufacturing of fertilizer in Missouri or Kansas, who does? The answer? Most of the time, it's the private sector. Now, it's the private sector, and it's the private sector and their insurance companies. The motivation, obviously, is to stay in business, and if the insurance companies won't write them a policy to stay in business because they believe that the facility might not be safe, well, then they're out of business, and that's the motivation on the private sector side, at least in Kansas and Missouri. That's the latest from here. Back to you.
Interesting information. Thank you, Michael. Technically, OSHA is supposed to be involved, but they often come in after an accident to figure out what happened.